Now, next thing what you are going to talk about is that means you know, emotions for that matter also tend to distort the. Hello everyone. In my previous video, I discussed the previous year questions which came from memory in 2024. This time, I'll be discussing about the questions that are going to appear in your 2023 UPSC CSE. Now, the first question that was there in CSC from memory was, is reconstructed memory accurate? Okay, so they are saying that they are asking you about reconstructed memory. Now, describe the process of reconstruction citing research evidence. Okay, now whatever you are saying, whatever you are talking, that should not be something you know, superficial. So you need to cite it with research. Once you cite it with research, what happens is that what gets a backing. Now they are saying that is reconstructed memory accurate. Now the point is, the reconstructed memory is what? That means the information that you are recalling, that means the information that was there in your memory, and when you are putting a light on it, so whether reconstructed memory is accurate or not. So let's begin. Now firstly, what you need to do is you need to explain what is reconstructed memory. And reconstructed memory is, that means the memory which is talking about, or memory which is able to recall the past recorded events. Fine. So that means reconstructed memory is actually focusing on your past recorded events. Now, is it accurate? So now there have been various research which have talked about the fact that a lot of information which was you know, gathered from reconstructed memory was found to be you know, inaccurate. And the reason being was, firstly, the language based on which the information is retained in the memory is going to be important before you, you know, reconstruct it. So for example, you know, you are talking about if an accident happened, for that matter, right? So if we say that, okay, when the accident happened, the car was at this speed. Now if somebody asks you that the dot time when the car hit the person, what was the speed? So this is like inaccurate information that is going to be provided. So language in which the information is getting stored . Now, next thing what you are going to talk about is, that means, you know, emotions for that matter also tend to distort the memory. Sometimes they, yes, helps you in having the vivid explanation, but at times too much emotion can also distort the memory. Too much emotion can distort the memory. Fine. Now, language, emotion is there. What else? Other than that, there are sigmas. Now, what are sigmas? Now, sigmas are the part in which you are going to talk about what? That means how your information or your knowledge is getting structured. Right? So, in that way, sigmas also play a big role. Now, here what you are going to talk about is, that means, you know, for example, there is a certain event that happened, right? Now, I am visualizing it through my way, right? So the information that is getting stored in my memory is my interpretation, whereas that information getting stored in the other person is their interpretation, right? So what is happening is here, interpretation of information matters. Fine, just a second. Okay, so language, emotions, sigmas, these are going here. What are you going to do is, you are going to cite the research evidence of Tubling. You can also talk about the research of Badley. Fine. Other than that, you can also talk about the studies and the research that are done by Loftus. Fine. Now, it's all your, you know, calling which of the researchers you are going to prefer. I have just quoted like three of them. You can actually quote more than five of them. I am just telling you how you are going to, you know, go about the question. Now, other than that, what they said was that describe the process of research reconstruction citing research evidence. Yeah, this is what I said, told you that, you know, it depends upon a lot many factors. It depends upon the emotion. For example, you know, too much heavy on emotions, then people might distort the information. Then there's one thing more, that means confidence also. Some people are very confident of detail even if the information is inaccurate. So that way, confidence also might lead to inaccuracy in reconstructed memory. Fine. So this is how you are going to deal with this question. Now let's move on to the next question. The next question says, how can the memory be improved, right? Now what they are saying is that, how can the memory be improved with the help of organization and mnemonics technique. Now you need to, you know, put light on, you need to put light over here onto two aspects. One is that how the information is getting organized and how the mnemonic techniques are being used for what, you know, for, yeah, for the information to be there in your memory. Fine. So let's start with how the organization of information is going to be helpful for you. Okay, now the first thing is they are saying is organization role. So here you can actually talk about first thing, how the information is arranged. Fine. Other than that, you are also going to write about the facts. For example, you know, to hold certain information, there is a capacity. So here, the capacity of the information, for example, the phone numbers that we remember are 10-digit numbers. So capacity of the information. Now, other than that, what they said was that information which is arranged, the capacity of the information that is being stored. Other than that, you can also talk about the mnemonics techniques in the organization part as well. Why? Because the mnemonic technique helps you in organizing the information. Now, further moving, how else the information can be organized? You can also talk about what semantic information, that means you peacefully you organize the information in pieces. Fine. First, I'll discuss about the mnemonics technique and then we'll talk about the researches. Fine. Now, in mnemonics, how you are going to, you know, use this information to organize, or how can the memory be improved for that matter? So, you know, mnemonics, what we can do is that here you can talk about what you can actually talk about acronyms. Then you can talk about, for that matter, memory loci. Sorry, memory loci. Locus. Right. Other than that, you can also focus on what, for that matter, chunking of words. In some cases, they remember it. The information in musical aspects or in musical form. Right? So, information is arranged, capacity is withheld, then mnemonics technique is there, then semantic information, that means organize information in pieces. Then in mnemonics technique, you are talking about acronyms, you are going to talk about memory loci, you are going to talk about chunking, you are going to talk about musical form. Now, the point is that what are those research evidences that are talking about here? For example, you know, in case of chunking and all, what you can do is that in both aspects, by the information, yeah. Here you can cite the research of Miller, for that matter. Yeah, you can cite the research of Miller. Fine. Other than that, what you can do in with respect to semantic information is you can also highlight the research, you know, these research evidences that are coming from Kavling's. Fine. Other than that, I told you about what in mnemonics part you can also talk about Crack and Tevling. Yeah, in the memory loci also we have got research from Crack, memory retention, right? Capacity also we had Crack and Tevling over here, both I have talked about capacity. So this was just a brief explanation that how you are going to you know, attempt the question. Right now I was able to recall only 2-3 parts of the various researchers. What you can do is that you can add on the information whichever you find is good enough. Fine. Thank you so much. In the next videos I'll be coming from the different questions with respect to the other. Thank you.